Kevin McCaffrey here from Treedent. In this 15-minute presentation and demo, I'm going to provide you with an overview and background on our CurateFX strategic planning platform, and also provide you with a demo of how this product is used for a variety of use cases, specifically in the area of digital transformation. One of the key challenges organizations are finding is that to transform and to change is not easy. And there are significant problems in doing this. And this change can result in many miscommunications and a lack of understanding between key stakeholders. And in some organizations, they're not quite sure where to start. In this little diagram here, it shows that most organizations, when they look at this, they kind of relate to it immediately and can say that most of the time, from a strategic planning perspective, they tend to use products such as Word and PowerPoint. And those are static products, and they're not very inclusive or encouraging for structured collaboration or engagement with different people. The other important point is in the area of best practices and understanding how you can leverage information and standards that are out there to do things better. So CurateFX delivers tangible benefits across the entire organization. In today's organizations, C-level people need to ensure that their teams are effectively collaborating. They need to ensure that the business and the IT team can work together to come up with a cohesive strategy or plan that'll enable the change within the organization to be successful. And that can be at a high level from a strategic vision, right down to, you know, process flows or detailed, you know, structure that would be required for process flows. Now, how we do that within CurateFX and what becomes important for us is when we empower our clients through our platform, they're able to create the strategic vision. They're able to do this in a structured, collaborative way where people are using a single kind of view of the truth. And that means that they're able to utilize a whole range of industry and business best practices. So what an organization and leaders within an organization want to be able to do, they want their projects to be successful. They want to be able to do it in the most efficient and effective way. And one of the strengths of being able to use a product like CurateFX is to leverage the industry and business best practices that exist in there. Now, you can pick and choose those elements that are relevant for you, because it could be a case that you're focused in one particular area and you want to focus on the business modeling side versus process flows. Our product has been recognized by Gartner and Forrester as a leading product in the area of business architecture, with specifically related to business ecosystem modeling and also strategic planning. Now, one of the areas that's important about CurateFX is you need to be able to help teams to start and to guide them through the journey of transformation or working on new projects. And to enable that, what we've done is we've built in a wide range of templates and also example projects that leverage the TM Forum's best practices. So all of these elements on these slides are included in the product as best practices for people to use. And it's not just around the TM Forum best practices, but it could also be in areas of the business, such as business modeling, business capabilities, process flows, Kanbans that could be integrated with Jira, and many more. Now, this presentation continues for quite a bit of time, and there's quite a range of other slides that talk about some of the key benefits, both at to individual users, but also around across the organization. We have also included some details on some of the organizations that are currently using our product as part of a collaboration program within the TM Forum. But what I want to do is I'm going to leave the PowerPoint and we're going to go into the product and have a quick look at one use case to show you how a team that is made up of four or five different companies collaborated to create a strategy for a new innovative approach that they wanted to take and go to market. There is also within the presentation that you receive some further information about the best practices and also actually links that will enable you to click and to actually, you know, view one of the example projects we're going to look at. So now, looking at CurateFX, let's take some of that theory that we've just talked about and bring that to life. So The concept of CurateFX is it's a SaaS product. It means it sits up on the cloud. It's accessible through browsers, so nothing has to be installed on people's machines. Very clear, clean in terms of operations and management. It's ISO 27001 certified, so security is a really important area. It's what's referred to as a multi-tenant environment, which means that each organization has its own workspace and users have different levels of access. And what they create is something called a project. So each of these little cards here represents a project. And I'm just in a demo area here. And what we're going to explore is a project that was created by an organization called Salesforce, which everybody would know. And they were working with Jaguar Land Rover. And Jaguar Land Rover came with the question and say, how can we use technology to improve our customer experience for our new electric vehicle? So that was the opening point. And within this overview page, you know, what the team did was they described it, they can define and understand who's going to be collaborating on this. They can actually link this project to other sources. It could be videos, it could be to their Confluence page. So all of this becomes kind of the central port where the team come together to collaborate on defining the strategy around this project. So what they did first was they said, well, look, we've got an important project, but before we get into the how, which are the technical side of things, we want to first figure out why we're doing this, make sure we understand the problems we're trying to solve, who the customer, you know, who, what's driving this from a customer's perspective and so on. And then they went into some more information, which we'll talk about in a moment. Within this landing page on this project, you've got the overview, you've got content, you've also got stakeholders. And these stakeholders are the list of the key participants that are required to make this project successful. They could be internal, they could be external, they could be companies. It's completely project context. But what is really important is that you've got this central list of stakeholders, plus also products and services. Because in many examples of projects, people are working in the concept of ecosystems. And an ecosystem is defined as a network of stakeholders or participants that interact with each other, you know, to generate value by providing products or services. So you want to have consistency when you're defining those products and services and those stakeholders. So you'll notice here within when I expand this area called overview, and that's just like a little heading like the table of contents, below that you've got these little cards. Each of these cards is what we refer to as a module. And you can think of a module very much as a PowerPoint slide that has a specific function and purpose. Now, in this situation, what you know, you can see it's being used as overall value, problem statements, drivers, ecosystem design. So each of them captures specific information, but they also help you storyboard the key aspects of the project you're trying to achieve. So before you get into the designs, and further down, you can see they talk about use cases and all of that. But first of all, they said, what's our vision? You know, so if we click on, for example, the vision module, it actually describes it and it says, you know, what they're trying to achieve is provide a personalized driver experience. And if I open up that, we can see that, you know, who are the stakeholders that have been associated with it. On the left-hand side, I've got a navigator that allows me to navigate through this. So, you know, we could go and look at particular things like, you know, what are the problem statements that have been defined? What are the key drivers from the customer's perspective? Again, really important information to gather this up front before you get into a lot of detail, because it's amazing how often teams, you know, bypass the obvious and don't have a clear agreement and structure on things such as your vision, your value, your drivers, and the problem statements. But what these guys did was they then created a view of the business model, because if they're looking at going to market with this, they want to understand how this business model will work. And within the tool, we're using the Osterwalder business model canvas as a best practice. And it allows them to be able to go and do things like filtering and say, hey, I want to see the areas within here that are relevant for our ecosystem partners, so we can filter and show that information. Now, the business model is useful, but actually, because it gives you a view using that standard, you know, structure of a canvas. But what people also want to see is how this project is brought to life. How does this business model work? Who does what? How does, you know, who delivers what products? What are the financial elements within there? And here within our product, we've created this concept of the business ecosystem designer. So what the team did here is they designed a visual representation of the ecosystem to show how information can move between the different stakeholders or other interactions. And you can see there's lots of different colors here to represent the different types of interactions. So using a simple filter, I can say, I want to see the flow of money. So we can select and say, okay, show me the financial interactions, or I want to see the flow of products and services. Now, what becomes important is as the team is building this together, you're going to have people from different aspects, but they've all got this single view of the ecosystem. But it also can help highlight where there's gaps. For example, you know, they haven't defined a relationship with the products for products and services from the computer, for the comm service provider. But also, if they wanted to add others, they would click in here on the left-hand side. It's a panel that's got a list of stakeholders. So I could drag, for example, an insurance stakeholder and, you know, create a link to Jaguar Land Rover and then choose that this is going to be a financial relationship and choose, you know, the type of relationship it's going to be. So it's really focusing the team on understanding the relationships between stakeholders. And this is so important at this early stage in defining an overall project. Now, the next thing that these guys did, and we're not going to go through all of the detail, is as we saw further down, they have a list of use cases that they defined around branded service, branded handover, personalized service. Because this is quite telecom centric, they then wanted to map this and say, well, you know, what are the business processes that we want to use? So within the tool, you've got the entire TM-Form framework. So the ETOM, SID, TAM, metrics, and they're there if people need them. But what these guys did was they were able to go and say, well, what are the business processes that are going to be needed for the use case of a branded handover? So they were able to tag those and highlight and see which products and services, and they could also assign stakeholders. So a very, very powerful way of being able to, you know, understand. And then they understand what are the process elements required. They then went into other areas and defined use cases, and they created an order to payment, you know, process flow. So lots of more detailed information in here. Now, they used a standard template to create this project, but at any stage, they could add their own module. And that own module is, remember, like I said, is one of these like PowerPoint slides that has a specific purpose. So they could choose things related to strategic planning. It could be anything from a risk module to SWOT analysis. They could look at best practices associated with the TM Forum. So they could be looking at the TM Forum's open digital architecture. They could be doing work around stakeholders. So there's all of these tools are available at their fingertips. But one important thing throughout the project is, as I said right at the start, is the significance of stakeholders and products and services. So as they're working with the project and they're assigning stakeholders, CreativeX is automatically tracking what they've assigned. So it actually enables you to see this through something called a stakeholders assignment matrix. So if, for example, we click on the city charging provider, it tells me what are the elements that they are associated with. But in a more visual way, you can look at that through something called a map. So here we've got the stakeholders, and I can look at one of these and say, well, let's look at, for example, the overall business model. So if we expand the overall business model and we look at the value proposition, I can actually look and say, who are the stakeholders that are going to drive that? So for senior people within an organization where they want traceability, they want to understand impact analysis, they can actually get right down and say, look, if we were making a change to the device management platform, who are the stakeholders that are going to be impacted? So this is a dynamic view across the entire project and an incredibly powerful way to understand the dynamics that exist within the project and the dependencies between the stakeholders. This is something that you can only achieve looking at this type of view, and not as people tend to try and do in Excel and Word and PowerPoint. So finally, back at the overview, one of the important things as well as you're working on the project is to be able to collaborate. And that's why, as I said, we've got this ability to share the project at a team level with individual users, or you can create a unique URL for the project that you can share with others. So I'm going to stop now. This is a very quick overview. We've kind of scratched the surface on the product, but really what we wanted to achieve here was to give you the overview and kind of highlight some of the key best practices and standards that exist within the project. So thank you.